What is up? We're here on the back day, and man, when I thought I was sore yesterday waking up, my God. The day after leg day, sure, you're gonna be a little bit sore, right? The second day after leg day is 100% worse. Just walking up the stairs to get to the gym here, that probably took me like 5 minutes just to get up those steps. But hey, we made it in. Even though we're sore, we're here. And we're starting with good old reliable lat pull downs. Just like normal, we're gonna start out with some moving the body a bit more, swinging a bit, just get the blood flowing and get the weight moving, as I like to say. Before my back days, warming up with forearms is definitely a added bonus. If I were to go into that set cold, even with the straps, I'm sure my forearms would already be on fire. So I always just like to do some like two sets of single arm wrist curls, go like 20 reps, add up the weight, and then go 10 reps. So it's really all your preference though. So I just said, fuck it, on the lat pull downs. I don't know, they weren't feeling super good. Figured I'd just move on. I do want to try later in the workout a different grip on pull downs. It's the outside grip like this, and it's like wider. So I'm definitely going to be dropping the weight for that and really just go slow and controlled then. That's why I skipped out on it in the first set of lat pull downs. Now we're just getting to the mid back trap. Using the favorite grip here. And yeah, we're gonna bang out probably 3 to 4 sets. I think this will be the only middle back movement I'll do today. I don't know, it's just a solid exercise and I think it's really all I need. But yeah, the only sucky part is that with this grip, you can't use straps. At least I haven't found a good way to use them with it. So, need bigger forearms as it is. Yeah, I don't know, this ain't feeling that good either. I think I'm gonna try out the machine row. I got so many like TikTok edits running through my brain at the beginnings of my set because I just started watching AOT again. And man, now they're starting to pop up on my For You page. I just finished season 2. So if you know how that finale went, that was a good way to end the season. So that's definitely getting me hyped up for the set. Hopefully, it'll feel better than the row, than the seated row. Thank you. And when I'm doing this, I'm making sure to, rather than having my elbow tight to my body and keeping it more, my hand placement more low, I'm putting my hands higher and flaring out my elbows so it doesn't engage the lats as much. Because for this one, I want it more mid back and traps. If you're trying to hit mid back, flare the elbow. If you're trying to hit lat, keep it tight. Man, okay. That was a great way to finish off mid-back. All right, so we're gonna try out that other grip on the lat pull-downs. Probably one, maybe two if it feels good. Then we'll be good for back. Okay, so yeah, just something different I wanted to try. I don't know, I can't really feel it much in my lats, and that's really what I'm going for, what I'm trying to target right now. So I think I'll be done with that. I'm glad I tried it though, you know, now I know I don't like it. No stone unturned, but let's just finish off with some one arm pull downs or pullovers. I'll just do one set just to get the last full percentage of the pump going. Oh, solid, good ass, motherfucking back day. What was that? 2, 4, 7, 8, 9 sets. I like to stay within the 8 to 12. I've kind of been lowering the volume, but upping the intensity. So don't need as many sets, as long as I get out as much intensity as possible. That's beautiful. All right, let's go check out this pump. Okay, so we're gonna be using what we got here. The gym is pretty full right now, so not trying to do it in there. But I haven't had the, what's the word? The opportunity to be in here without this top light on above me. So right now we only have lights right in front and above. So it's a little bit different. We'll see if the pump looks any better or looks any worse. So let's get this down a bit. Not too much because it's already decently dark in here. But shit. It's getting to the point where I might need to get a haircut soon. It's getting a little bit too fluffy for my liking. But man, when I switched to the, all right, we'll talk about this in the car. Actually, let's just get this pose down in. Yeah, the lats are actually feeling pretty decently pumped right now. I like that, I like that. Okay, so yeah, we'll have to see how those look in the post-production, but I think I'm gonna like it. Oh man, I'm gonna do abs for sure, but man, my legs are sore as hell. So I might just do the 10 minutes of cardio again. I'd say doing the extra stuff is all about, not necessarily when you feel motivated to do it, but when you're bodily abled, as in you're not sore. Obviously, if you're just a little bit fatigued, you're just like, oh, they hurt a little bit, you know, I don't want to push them too hard, then do it. But like, if they're still sore as hell and it's like you're struggling to walk, you don't really need to push it that hard. So, or I'm just making excuses right now and I'm being a bitch. Either way, we're gonna do 10 minutes of cardio and do abs. I'll see you guys in the car. Man, isn't it crazy how going to the gym early gets you out of the gym early? Crazy how that works, huh? It is, it's not even 10:45, so I'm gonna be able to get home. Now granted, I didn't drink my protein shake and I still got like 1200 calories to go, so I will be up eating for a little bit, but I should be able to get into bed by 11:30 tonight, and then boom, that'll be 7 hours of sleep right there. So that's a fantastic way to end off a good back day. That's all I know. I don't know what was up. Just something kind of fell off with the lat pull downs. I don't know, they just weren't hitting the same today. So, and like I've said many times before, if you feel a certain exercise isn't feeling good that day, or it isn't hitting the muscle how you want it to, there's no reason to not switch it up. One, that'll get you some variety in your lifts, so you could be hitting the muscle differently. Not saying it always will hit it differently, but if it's a different grip, a different exercise for the same muscle group, it's gonna hit it slightly differently. So you might feel it in a different way. And two, just getting some variety to your lifts, it helps you. What am I trying to say? It helps keep you engaged in your lifts. Because if you just do the same exact exercises every single day, every single week, then your lifts are gonna get stale and you're not gonna enjoy it. That's why you gotta, like I did today, find a different exercise. Go on TikTok, go on Google, go on YouTube, see what other people are doing and try it out. If it works, great. You got a new exercise to put in your arsenal. And if it doesn't, you don't like how it feels, then now you know. Now you don't gotta wonder if it's gonna hit any better or not. So, I don't know. That's just what I kinda like to live by in life, but mostly in the gym. Try new shit. You're not gonna know. Don't diss it until you try it. Pretty much is what I'm trying to say. But man, these past couple of days have just been, I'm assuming you can hear it right now, but it's just been raining nonstop. Like today it was kind of just cloudy throughout the whole day, a little bit drizzling and stuff. But yesterday it was like a consistent rain literally the whole day. So it's just been gloomy as hell. So that's why I took 2 scoops of pre today. Had to feel extra amped up. And it got me motivated to hit a good back day today. So I know this weight doesn't count, but I hit 205 today on the scale at the gym. Now it was after cardio and after abs and stuff, so I sweat a little bit off. But yeah, man, 205 on the scale. Obviously not counting it because I only count morning weight. Once I've shit and pissed everything out of my system, that's like my actual body weight. But yeah, it's exciting to see. That's a number I've never hit before. And boom, even with 1,200 calories to go left in the day. So yeah, it's exciting. That's why I like to measure myself twice, maybe three times a week. Because if you measure yourself every day, then your weight fluctuates. You're gonna see it go down, you're gonna see it go up, you're gonna see it stay the same. So that's why you just measure yourself two times a week, maybe three, and you should see a consistent progress, either down or up, whatever you're going for. Oh yeah, this is what I was going to start talking about when we were in the pose down, checking the pump. After I hit those ab rollers, the rollouts, I switched it up. Instead of just the cable crunches, I did the ab rollers. And like I've been saying, it hit the muscle differently. And today I woke up pretty damn sore in the abs, which is a great sign. I love it and I hate it. I love it because that's how I know I hit abs good, because I'm sore, and I hit them in a way that I haven't hit them before, or in a while at least. But the sucky thing was literally doing anything else throughout the day. Sitting up, sitting down, twisting one way, picking something up, man, I'm just like, oh, sore throughout the whole day. Even laughing, dude, laughing even hurts. So it's a blessing and a curse to hit abs. But yeah, when I stay consistent with hitting abs pretty much every day, once I cut down after the end of the year, I should have a pretty decent six pack going on. I might even see some muscle that I haven't seen before, because doing abs every day, eating a shit ton of food, getting a shit ton of protein in, that's going to grow your abs no matter what. Not necessarily grow them, but make them pop more. So yeah, this cut will definitely be exciting to see. Again, this is my first ever like official bulk, like actual bulk. I've tried eating a little bit more, but I've never like tracked my macros, made sure to weigh myself every week, nothing like that. So this will definitely be exciting. If you can't tell, I'm starting to get a little distasteful of this bulk. I'm still gonna push through it. I got about 2 months left, maybe a little bit less. But man, I'm definitely excited to see what the cut will look like. I'm just envisioning it now, because I've noticed when I'm doing my back poses, 100% the definition has gone down. I can definitely see my size increasing, like I'm getting wider. I'm getting more dense, I guess. But yeah, the definition has definitely gone down, which it's a good sign, but it's also kind of tough on the mental to see that. I just got to stop thinking about the cut right now. I really just got to lock in and focus for these last 2 months and just dial in. And then the cut will just be that much better. So news on Florida. Today is Thursday. It's Thursday night. And we are going to be leaving Sunday, actually. So not Saturday. So I should have a Saturday upload. Maybe a Sunday upload. Probably not, though, because our flight's in the morning on Sunday. We're going to be in Florida. We're going to check out some houses. Go to some Halloween parties. I still gotta pick out my costume. I don't got a costume to wear right now. So I gotta find that. within the next couple of days here. And yeah, then I should be a decent amount tanner, because I'm planning on being out in the sun a lot, because you got to enjoy that Florida weather, you know, especially when you're leaving and then coming back home to 40 degrees and raining. So I'm not looking forward to that, but the 4 days that we're in Florida, I'll be sure to enjoy it. But yeah, that's gonna do it. What will we be hitting? Probably arms. I don't know. I've just kind of gotten, I don't want to say I'm bored of arm day, but I'm looking forward to it less. Like I'm starting to enjoy chest and back more than I am arms, when it used to be the opposite. But you know, that always happens. You're always gonna, it's kind of like phases in the gym. Like I used to love leg day, now I absolutely despise it. And then I'll probably end up loving it later down the road, but not right now, that's for sure. Fought leg day, that's his ass. But yeah, all right, arm day tomorrow. Should be a good one. Gonna be getting a good ass pump, I hope. Man, it is foggy on my road here. And yeah, that's gonna do it. Peace out, brother.